Wow.
Ah, shit.
That hurt my hip, bro.
Fucking leg day was yesterday, bro. Oh my god. Oh.
If you watched my previous videos before, you probably heard that I had like the most stereotypical body transformation story. I was down bad. I weighed like 110 pounds and I played Fortnite 24/7. And then I became fucking Adonis, a Giga Chad, I don't know, Adonis. I said Adonis, bro. But in order for me to even get motivated to go to the gym, I needed self-improvement videos to get me to start learning all these new habits and tips and tricks. It's probably because I didn't have someone there for me. My dad was never into fitness. So I always thought that I needed some type of mentorship in order to move forward in my self-improvement journey. And I felt kind of lost because I didn't have anyone in my in real life relationships that motivated me to push myself to go beyond consuming and just living this horrible lifestyle. So I went to Matt Diavella to build habits. I went to Ice Cold JT to get motivation. I went to Nathaniel Drew for structure. I went to Hamza for a fucking existential crisis.
Jeffrey's suicidal because he's 5'7".
But when I was watching a Joe Rogan clip on YouTube, he was interviewing Chuck Panuku.
Check out Bike Club by Chuck Palahniuk. For trial with a free audiobook, go to audible.com.
I'm not gonna go to audible.com.
There needs to be a secondary father in men's lives, that you're born, if you're lucky, with a biological father that you do not choose, and that is the nurturing, loving father that you eventually kind of have to reject. But in doing so, you have to choose a new father, and that father by choice typically is a minister or a teacher or a drill sergeant or a coach, one of those fathers, and you kind of put yourself in apprenticeship to the secondary father.
And it felt incredibly satisfying, the fact that each time I went to watch these self-improvement YouTube videos, it felt like I was just comfortable. It felt like there was some type of catharsis release where all my built-up anxieties and insecurities about how I looked before, how I was so skinny, how I was doing so poorly in school.
And it felt like these self-improvement YouTubers were living the same life as me, as if these videos were portraying similar problems that I had to go through, and they use these self-improvement habits and skills to address their problems. And even if I've already learned these habits that these YouTubers have taught me, I would still keep going to watch these YouTube videos regardless, because it was just comforting, the fact that people were talking about their own experiences of how they face these challenges, and it just felt relatable. And when I went to my family to go talk about my own struggles, it didn't seem like there was that sense of connection as if I were to go to self-improvement videos, because it would just be so awkward to ask my parents like, oh, how to get to day 90 on OFAP. That'd just be so weird. And after my first month going to the gym, I still felt self-conscious, yet these videos made me feel so proud of my own progress, because I was developing them with a person who's already teaching me these skills, and this relationship with the content creator, with the YouTuber, just becomes personal. Or maybe I just want someone to say to me,
I'm proud of you, son. And I never really got that bit.
It's 10 a.m. and he's accomplished like 4 things. And Alyssa just turned to him and said, bro, I'm so proud of you. Like a year ago, like think about how different that is. You've literally meditated twice today. Think about like if Sam from 2 years ago knew. Sam from 2 years ago was like, I've got to put this in your mind, bro. Sam from 2 years ago was literally live streaming on Twitch for literally like 12, you know those guys who live stream and they have like 3 viewers? Sam was one of them.
And this self-improvement community just made me feel so insanely proud of my progress. I was showing my transformation pictures to all my friends and family, and they all hyped me up. I realized that the only person in my family that I didn't show was my dad. And maybe it was just subconsciously, maybe I was thinking, yeah, he probably wouldn't really care anyways. You know, I was like, fuck it. He should be one of the people that should be most important to me in my masculinity. I should look up to him, and there's no way he would disregard it. It's something that I'm so proud of, something that I've been working so hard for. But when I showed it to him, he glanced up and he just kept staring at his phone. He didn't care. And that shit hurt a lot. In some sense, the fact that the self-improvement community made me feel so proud of my own work, yet my own father didn't really care at all, made me think a lot differently about how I should continue my hard work and dedication. Because going through years of going to the gym and having your friends, your family, everyone that you love proud of you. But the only person in your life that should be the person that you look up to for all these masculine traits that doesn't feel proud of your own work is so unsatisfying. And after I showed him the picture and he didn't care, I didn't really talk to him the rest of the day. I was kind of bummed out, not gonna lie. I went back to my room and I just binge watched self-help videos again. Right now, I think I've reached to a point where I am so sick of watching self-help because I was constantly consuming and I already learned everything.
There is a point that my videos won't help you anymore. And at that point, it is your responsibility to stop watching and to then prioritize like being in the real world, because you've like gotten to the point where self-improvement's become somewhat automatic. You know, it's always nice to get like a sense of repetition. So that's why I continue watching videos by the YouTuber first, man. It's always like, even if you're gonna hear the same thing over and over again, that repetition does help. But there is a point when you're not necessarily gonna need to hear it from me anymore.
And now I just went to self-help for comfort, because that I knew that I was only trying to make up for my dad's failures. And I turned self-help to self-validation now. I want you guys to realize this too. Maybe the reason why you're constantly watching self-improvement videos is because it might be that you're lacking a sense of mentorship in your relationships. And perhaps the best course of action is to simply ask yourself, why is that? And consider why your relationships are the way that they are.
You know what, this is kind of hard for me to admit, because I've been thinking about this for a couple months now. Right now, I'm 18, and I think that this is like the best age for someone who needs a father figure, who someone teaching them these skills so that they can develop them to become their own father figure. I don't know if it's like the lack of emotional connection or loneliness or just something that I'm lacking. And I'm really trying to be really self-aware about this, but I really don't know where to go beyond self-help, because I only kept consuming all this content so that I could feel that someone's there for me, so that there's someone along the journey with me. And right now, I just feel lost. I think I just really need direction. If I leave self-help right now, which is very beneficial because I don't need to be consuming so much content, but where would I go? My dad's not there for me to be supportive as much as self-help would. How do I find that sense of mentorship?
Remember Officer and a Gentleman?
Yeah.
You know, Richard Gere really has this drunken, this not their dad. And then he has this drill sergeant who's constantly trying to wash him out. And then finally he reaches the existential crisis of saying, you can't throw me out of the service because I have nothing else. I have nowhere else to go in the world. My life will amount to nothing unless I can master this thing. And he's a relatively young man, but it is that existentialistic moment where you realize that you have to sacrifice your youth for something. You're not going to live forever. It's a very Martin Heidegger moment where you realize you have to become a being living towards death. You're not going to live forever, and you've got to give your life to something.
And I think this one clip has really changed my perspective a lot. It might be time for myself to start taking responsibility to become my own father figure. A lot of people who reach a certain age or maturity, they gotta start taking responsibility of becoming their own mentor. Like what Chuck said, you gotta be at that existential moment where you gotta reject the people who've been constantly spoon-feeding you advice and start taking your own action. I was actually thinking back to a conversation that I had with my dad, and I remember he was telling me that in his early 20s, his dad passed away to cancer. And through this, he ended up moving to Canada and started his own family. He created his own little business, and he started just having his own life. And I thought that this was awesome. He made his own purpose. It seemed that it was at that point where his dad passed away was only when he made this move. And I was thinking, as morbidly as this sounds, do I need to wait for my dad to pass in order to create my own legacy now? I think a lot of people at a certain age, they just got to realize that they got to go beyond self-improvement and they gotta stop relying on other people's advice and start taking responsibility for themselves. Right now, at my age, it might be a little bit too young, or maybe if people who are younger than me, and they've already realized this, you just gotta be really introspective about this. Talk to other people. Be very transparent with the people in your lives who are giving you advice, because I think that once you reach a certain age, you gotta become your own father figure. I'm not saying that you should start your own fucking family. I'm saying that you should be your own person. You gotta start fending for yourself, thinking your own thoughts, find your own purpose. I hope that those people who are a bit directionless, that once you realize that you've watched too many videos and you don't need this mentorship anymore, you gotta start finding what you need to do in order to begin becoming your own father figure. And I feel like I've been saying that phrase so much. And okay, what does it mean to be your own father figure? It should be the person who you look up most to in masculine traits, in skills, in responsibility. A lot of myself, I've been looking at, like, let's take an example for Hamza. He always shows the Jeffrey to Adonis transformation and always tells him the values and all the traits that Adonis should exhibit to the world. That's the reason why he's so popular right now. It's because he's telling people that you should follow this epitome of masculinity. The reason why I felt like I was so consumed by his content was because I was going to his videos just for a sense of comfort, because of the fact that these traits were supporting me through my self-improvement journey. But now, once you go beyond watching all these videos and learning all these habits and skills, you gotta start looking in yourself for all these masculine traits and skills now. And I think that this might be one of the most important steps in self-improvement, is to go beyond it. It's like the final boss or whatever. I love my father for telling me to take off the gloves, cause everything he didn't want was everything I was. Until my partners that figured it out without a father, I salute you, may your blessings be neutral to your toddlers. It's crucial, they can't stop us if we see the mistakes. Till then, let's give the women a break. Grown men with daddy issues.